All right, well, I played with these last week. Now I guess I'm going to tear them apart and see what they look like inside. They ran real nice. And I'm going to start. The whole thing is put together with hex keys, so. Pop off the head. There's the exhaust valve lifter. Set on the engine like this. It's got a cup for the rod to go into and a raised tapper round knob to hit the valve lid. So that's nice. Alright, that doesn't just slide off of there yet. Right. The two bolts that hold the valve rocker are slightly longer than the other head bolts. Figure out how to look through my camera. There we go. Valves are okay there. There's a little copper head gasket on here that hops right off. No machining to register it on there, it just sits. I don't know if the camera's going to focus on that, but these are cute little proper valves. Oh, and the spark plug is deep in that hole wall. So, if you're having issues with your engine, might be because that plug is so deep in there. The needle valve is in nice shape there. It's not weirdly formed or anything. So the carburetor came off, but it was on there with sealant, even though it does have a tiny copper gasket there. Yeah, and that's just a simple Venturi tube with the needle valve in it. It's not quite straight with the airflow. Of course, the muffler is just a piece of machined brass. It's got the center hole there, and then they drilled it crossways twice, so it has four holes coming out of it. So the bearing on the end of the push rod here is what keeps it from coming through that brass fixture that's on it. Pop the connecting rod and bearing cap off and take a look. I probably won't go too much farther because I don't want to mess with timing this in the Hall sensor. I'm afraid if I start pulling apart too much of the crankshaft from the flywheel side, I'll get that. So. And that connecting rod is bigger than the piston, so it won't go out that way. Alright. However, it does push out far enough. Can see that it's just an aluminum piston, carbon on it from running it the other weekend, with a silicone O-ring and an empty ring slot here, probably to help hold oil once you get oil up in there. These already have enough compression, so I doubt that putting another ring in there would help anything, although somebody could do that if they were so inclined. And we just learned something really valuable. Definitely a solid crankshaft because the brass bearing on the connecting rod is split. So. Huh. Okay. Set screw on the pull starter is 2 millimeter. The other screws so far have been 2.5. Well, that must be Loctited together. Well, like I said, I don't want to tear apart the flywheel end since it's in time and I don't want to mess that up. I was going to pull this off so I could point. Time to get up and look through the camera again. Alright. There's a set screw between the flywheel spokes there, and a matching one on the other side there that hold the flywheels in place. Which means that on the other side here, the two landings where they've got the set screws in are actually covered by the arms back here to operate the hit and miss governor. So, of course, that's all brass. Oh, and one last thing. I was going to take the main bearing caps off and see what kind of bearings are in there. Gonna remove the crankshaft because I don't have any reference marks on the timing gears right now. And I do not want to deal with that. Since all the other videos I watched on YouTube about this were talking about how they started tearing it apart and got out of timing. Alright, clean little aluminum cap, and it's just a stainless steel or steel bushing in there, it looks like. Yeah. I said can't get too far in there because I don't have any timing marks on my valve gears right now. So the water jacket on this is made out of three pieces, top cover, the cylinder bore forms a part, it's got a set screw there that holds the cylinder in, so it's effectively a big sleeve. Whatever's keeping that watertight, I don't want to disturb, so carefully. See, there is on this head gasket a little hot spot right there that looks like there might have been a cylinder leak, so that's interesting. Let's see. Let's. Oh, if I set that on there just like that, this discoloration matches the carburetor, and that would match up with the exhaust, so that might be... why that discoloration is happening, but make sure we put this on the way it came off, because I don't know how that's been deformed, and I don't want to... lose compression because I flipped the head gasket around. So I can see better to get this on. This is a smaller one, 2.5 millimeter. Just not using a bolt pattern yet, I'm just making sure that they're in and touching, and then I'll give them a quick nip with a bolt pattern. Alright. They're all nipped up, so I'll start next to the carburetor here. One. Go all the way across here. Two. And then I guess that's number four. And then hit number two in a clockwise pattern. Five. Three, six, and then go around again, but they're all, none of them loosened any since I got to the last one, and I'm not. Gonna over tighten those obviously because it's an all aluminum head and cylinder and everything. Throw the needle valve back in there. I might trade the needle valve between the two carburetors and the two engines and see if that changes the way that they act, but yeah. Nice little toys. Oh, and I still have compression, so I didn't screw up the silicone ring or anything. Oh, I'm looking at this cam lobe. And I'll try and tilt it here. But you can see it's not a full, like, kind of pointy lobe. It's got the angle here, and then it's been flattened off the top.